What if I hit the accelerator? Let's see if it'll just let me run them over. Oh, so it steers away from the person when I hit the accelerator. So I'm gonna hit it again. So it's just gonna steer away from the person. That's a pretty good decision. We're gonna see what happens if you come across dead bodies in the road. You never know, you know, one in a million. Car has to be able to handle everything, right? That's what people say. Love five? Gotta be able to handle everything. A bridge collapse and the car is on it. It has to be able to fly away. So last night, as you can see, we had a pretty decent winter storm. We had snow, we had ice, we had rain, and then it cooled off and it all froze. So out here, we're in my driveway, it's just snow everywhere. And so I wanna see how Full Self Driving Beta can handle this. So you can see there's my driveway down there, and it's all snow. I have not driven on it at all yet. So I wanna see if the system can even pick up where to drive, how it can drive, and then I have a private dirt road that is 100% completely ice covered. But we can kind of play around out there a little bit, let the system try to deal with the ice and the snow. And I have some props too. I have some cones, I have an inflatable dog, and I have a person. We can kind of mess around with that stuff and see how the car does in different situations with really slippery conditions. Now I will say, I wouldn't even be driving in this. I actually have a package that was supposed to be here like 4 days ago and it's still not here because they keep canceling it due to the bad weather. So this is like not even human driving conditions. Or like I said online, does this mean humans aren't even level 5 full self-driving if they can't handle every condition? I don't think so. But for fun, let's just see what the car can do, even though it'll probably be pretty tough. So let's start out with going down the driveway, driving down the road, and seeing if the car can get down the street and take a right turn. Also, as I'm out here testing, I didn't even say this is beta 9, the latest version, and I do not have snow tires on my Model 3. So this is all without snow tires. We have them on the other car, so if we have a day like this and I have to go out, I'll just take the other car. That's why I don't get snow tires for the 3. All right, so getting started here, definitely gotta be in Santa mode. Got the reindeer going. And right away, we'll see. Autopilot is available, so the car will let me turn autopilot on, so let's just do it. The only problem, it's going to want to go really fast, so I will quickly turn that down. I think 5 miles per hour will be good for me, and it's actually not doing a terrible job, so I do put these kind of sticks up to show anyone using the driveway where to drive, and wow, I'm actually pretty surprised it's doing very well on knowing where to go. So this is normally a grass little cul-de-sac, and it's going around it. Now, to be fair, it does sometimes drive through it, but so do people. So like pretty much everyone that comes over just drives right through it. So I'm fine with that. And so far, this is pretty impressive. Now we're going really slow. Let's speed it up a little bit. We'll go 15. And it is staying in the road. It's not slipping. Now we're gonna have a stop coming up here. Oh, that's the turn signal noise. Forgot about that, that's annoying. Okay, it only does it for a second. So let's see, stopping, and sliding, okay, a little bit of sliding. Now the thing with auto, ooh, okay, here's my neighbor walking their dog. I don't wanna freak them out, I'm probably not gonna interact with them. But you can see they are displayed on the screen. So the thing with autopilot is, okay, so they're gonna, all right, let's let it go, let's let it go. So yeah, I'm gonna just take over there, because it's not moving over soon enough. Okay, so overall, a little bit of snow driving, really not too big of a deal. Can turn it on, oh, nope, not yet. Okay, so we can turn it on again. Let's just let it go full speed, see what it does. Now it's going off into the grass a little bit, so that's not good. It is really hard to see the edge of the road. Yeah, so then there it just freaked out and told me to take over. So full speed it's not quite ready for. Let's just do it one more time, why not? Or 10 more times, who cares? So it's definitely slipping. It's applying too much power to the wheels and they're spinning. So the biggest issue right now with autopilot is it doesn't see snow and then go, ooh, I need to accelerate slower, I need to brake slower, I need to brake earlier, things like that. So now the car's just stopped, it's not doing anything. So I don't think it's gonna move from here. This is so funny, look at this little Santa and his reindeer. So I wonder, like, if you turn the turn signal on. No, it doesn't show on there. Okay. So anyway, yeah, that's the biggest problem. It doesn't modulate driving behavior based on the conditions. Once it does that, it looks like it can see decently well. Now that's only a very small test, but so you can see how slippery it is. It's just slipping everywhere. Okay, so now I've set up some cones at the end of my driveway just to see how the car will do. There's nowhere to go. It has to stop, basically. So let's see. I can turn that on. Always got to turn it down. Again, I think 5 I'm good with in case it wants to drive off the driveway. And there are the cones. They are displayed there. You can see those red dots and my camera is also recording there. So it's trying to go around. Yeah, and it basically realizes there's nothing I can do here and it just stops. So that's really good coming around that corner.
Okay, so now I've set up kind of a little gauntlet here. I have cones down for it to kind of move through. Ooh, confused there. That's all right. I have cones for it to move through and a dog on the course, an inflatable dog. And oh yeah, see now it's confused even though before it was doing okay here. Let me move up a little bit more. I don't know if that could be because of the wheel slipping. As I'm driving, it's getting packed down, it's getting more slippery. So that could be messing it up, I'm not sure. Let's go, we're ready. Thinks it sees a person over there. There is no person. I'm gonna touch the accelerator. Oh, it said stopped at the intersection. That's weird. All right, I think 5 is pretty good. I did make this pretty tight. From the outside, it looked okay, but it is pathing through there correctly. Oh, it's just gonna go around. No, go through my course. Nope, yeah, all right, let me line it up a little bit.
Of course, neighbor pulls up as I'm filming this goofy stuff. Whatever. Okay, so I moved that first cone. And they're like, you know what? I'm leaving. This guy's weird. Okay, so I moved that first cone. So hopefully it can do a better job here. Oh, 15's too fast.
Nope.
Those cones are good. I thought it might have hit it. And going around. Yeah, I made this way too tight. Oh, it's trying to go this way. Okay, I mean, you can do that. That is the road still. Nice and slow. Look at that. It did it. Avoided the dog. Avoided the cones. Keep going. I'm gonna touch the accelerator. Wow, all right. Not the path I wanted it to take, but looking back, oh, it did touch one cone back there. All right, which you'll see on the other camera. Okay, so in this one, I've set it up. I made the cones kind of aim for the dog. I know the car can fit through there though, because I drove through here with this exact setup. So let's see what it does. It does display the dog. It kind of looks like the person box. But yeah, it's very nicely going around. It's gonna avoid my camera. Yes, it is. Very good. So that was good. We can see how close it got. And then let's make it impossible to get through there without hitting the dog and see what it does. Man, these side cameras, like look at this situation. Obviously, if this was a real dog, I wouldn't be doing this, but I can just back right through there. Okay, here we go. No escape. You must hit the dog or stop. I know 5 is slow. Let's bump it up to 10 and see what it does. Just don't want it to go off the driveway. Okay, so 8 miles an hour, sees the dog. It's trying to decide what to do. No, 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 how could you? Car's like, I must get you to your destination. This inflatable dog means nothing. Oh, poor pup. Now y'all see why I disengage so early when people are around. So not the most realistic. I mean, this is the way people walk their dogs, right? It's the best way I could get him to stand up. So we'll see if a human's life is more valuable than a dog's. Oh, the car's sliding. Okay, so it stopped in time. So yeah, this human is more valuable than the dog inflatable. The thing is so scary. I walked out into the garage. It was standing there. It scared the crap out of me. Okay. So it's just stopped. It's kind of trying to decide what to do. It knows there's cones. It knows there's a person. I only see one box. Is that what I'm seeing? A single box? Yeah. Kind of looks like 2 inside of each other. I'm not sure, but at least one box. So it's deciding not to go. Let's try. So I guess it's just going to sit there in the current state. There's obviously always a human here in the seat. So it's okay to just sit there. All right. Try that same scenario. One more time, 10 miles an hour. Sees the person, hits the brakes, sliding, stops. That was much better than last time. So it just stops. What if I hit the accelerator? Let's see if it'll just let me run them over. So I'm letting off. Okay, accelerator. Oh, so it steers away from the person when I hit the accelerator. So I'm gonna hit it again. Yep, so it's just gonna steer away from the person. That's a pretty good decision. There's cones, person, you obviously should hit the cones. If I keep hitting accelerator, keep hitting. Yeah, it's just gonna drive right over those cones, which, you know, if I'm asleep or something stupid and I'm telling it to go, that was actually a really good decision. Let's try one more time, see if that was a fluke. Yeah, a lot of sliding here. As I drive on this more and more, it's getting worse. I don't know why it thinks there's a person over there. It's almost kind of scary. It's consistently saying that, and there is just trees. Unless somebody's hiding behind the trees. All right, let's go. I'm going to hit the accelerator. Oh, stopped at traffic control. Very strange. Oh, now it's going on its own. And sees the person. Slams on the brakes for him and steers away from them. So that's a pretty consistent behavior of sees a person, can't stop, steers away from them. That is very cool. Poor doggo, though. That didn't happen. Let's do just the dog again and see if it'll do that for the dog this time. All right, here we go. Let's hope you stop or avoid the doggo. Yeah, too much slippage happening there. So we got to start at the top of this little hill, I guess. My neighbor's just like staring over there. Go ahead. This is not an intersection. All right. So speeding up. I guess that's about the speed I would drive. Okay, so avoids the dog, slams on the brakes. Okay, so that time it did. So maybe running over the dog was a fluke. Try the dog one more time. Let's leave it at 20. Let's see what it does. Wildly inappropriate. Okay, actually, it did control itself. That's pretty nice. Sees the dog, avoids. Okay, I would say the dog hit was a fluke, but hey, if that happens, you know, even 1 in 1,000 times, that's not good, but it's not done, so it's okay. All right, getting pretty close to the end of the tests here. Not an intersection. We're gonna see what happens if you come across dead bodies in the road. You never know, you know, 1 in 1,000,000. Car has to be able to handle everything, right? That's what people say. Love five? Gotta be able to handle everything. A bridge collapse and the car is on it. It has to be able to fly away. So avoiding the dead bodies. Oh, and it freaks out. Very good. Great job avoiding dead bodies there. One more time for consistency. This is very scientific. We gotta make sure we repeat. She's looking at me as she drives away. I'm not a weirdo, I swear. Final dead body test, 15 miles per hour. Oh, that's the mailman. Maybe I can stop him and get stuff from him. Oh, avoid! Avoids the dead body! Oh, it's swarming all over. Hey, this is pretty sweet. Nice job. Avoids the dead bodies. I think I might have a cone under there, but not bad. I'll take it. All right, final test. You know, if you've been watching the videos, whenever somebody is on the side of the road walking or with a dog or whatever, I take over super early because that's what I'm most comfortable with, but now we can kind of play around with these guys. Now, I assume the car will avoid them, although we did hit this little plastic dog earlier. So let's just see. Now I can really let the car do whatever it wants. So it is going to go around them, and that's a pretty normal, you know, spot for people to be when they're walking. So yeah, it goes around and moves back to the right. So too fast, like I'm sliding right now, for the snow. But beyond that, it is going around the person. So let's back up and try from a little farther away. Okay, so we're coming from right here. We'll do 20 of them. Okay with that. So we're really going straight forward. Like, this is where I would be like, let's move. So now it does it. Still a tiny bit late and a little close, I think, in my opinion. But you'll see it on the other cam. You can make your own opinion on that. And here we go. Whee! Just sliding away. All ice. One last one. I moved the dog farther out into the road. It's getting so slippery now. But we will see what the car does. Yep, does drive around it, not even sliding, which is pretty good. I assume that was pretty close, but everybody's happy. So let's do one last one. I'm going to just run this guy over. Let's see if the car will let me run him over in manual mode. All right, so now I am driving. This is when you have problems, human at the wheel, not autopilot. Let's see if it'll let me run into this person. Something is displayed there, human-dog hybrid. Oh, warns me, blam, does not stop me. But it did sound an alarm to tell me, hey, you're about to hit that human-dog hybrid there. So pretty good. So overall, I'm very impressed with Autopilot's performance here. It seems that pathfinding in the snow is not really a big deal. We could do some more, but like I said, right now the roads are ice, so I'm not going anywhere besides this little road here. It did run into the dog one time. Every time with a human, though, it avoided them and crashed into some cones instead of a person. So it looks like it has that built in where it will avoid people. If it cannot make another decision, it's going to hit something else rather than a person, which is pretty cool. And then the only problem for snow driving right now is just changing the driving behavior in the conditions, but I have no doubt that that will come eventually. early. I get a lot of comments seeing the abilities today and saying, oh, this is 10 years away or 5 years away. But just a reminder, a year ago, my car could not stop at stop signs and stoplights. A couple of months ago, it could not make right turns, left turns, do roundabouts, any of that stuff. So one software update really can change everything. And if the car can detect the conditions appropriately, which of course it knows the exterior temperature, the cameras can hopefully see snow, which sounds easy to me from somebody who doesn't code anything and knows nothing, but sounds easy. If the car can know all of those things, it can make the right decisions on accelerating slower, maybe put the car into chill mode on its own, braking much earlier as it needs to. So overall, pretty impressive. If you enjoyed this, hit like, get subscribed. I will talk to you down in the comments and you will see me in the next video.
So Autopilot and I are happily driving along.